opening back up our form navigator, we see we've got our main form and all our controls below it. If I right-click on main form, bring up the properties, on our general tab, we see the name of main form. The events, we have nothing in there. Our data tab is the one we're most interested in. We've got the content type of table. Our content is the table employees. And we've got that sorted by last name ascending, then first name descending. I'm going to save and close this form. And now I'm going to open up the form we just created with the subform. In edit mode, I'm going to open up our form navigator. And here we've got a main form and the controls underneath. One of them is called subform. Let's look at the main form first and see if anything's changed. I'm going to right click and open the properties. We see the general tab's got the name main form, no events. The data, we've got our content type of table, content employees, and this one's not sorted at all. If I click on the subform, we've got a little plus sign here. And we've got something called subform grid. So this is our control under the subform. If I go back to the subform, under our general tab, we've got the name subform. We don't have any events. Looking back in our data tab, we've got a content type of table. This content is the employee phone number table. Then when we come down a little further, we see something that's called link master fields, link slave fields. They're both set to employee ID. We know that employee ID is the field that we have to connect our employees and the employee phone number table. This information will help us when we set up our subform on our other form. Let's go back into that. We don't want to save any changes. Going to open this back up in edit mode. I want to open up the form navigator. I'm going to move this over to the right a little bit. Under our main form, we want to add a new form. So I'm going to right click on main form. Under new, I want form, and it's adding it down here at the bottom. I'm going to right click and open up the properties. Under general, instead of form, we're going to call this subform EMP phone. Events, we don't have any events. Now we come back to data. We want this a content type of table. We want the content to be the employee phone number table. Then down under the slave and master fields, if we click this down arrow, we don't see anything. If I click my dialog dot 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 box, it opens up the link fields dialog. Now we see our two tables, our employees table and our employee phone number table. We know that we want to link up employee ID to employee ID. I'm going to click OK. And there we see that they're in the link and master fields. I'm going to close this. We're not done yet. We still need to add in a control onto our new subform. Right now, we just have an empty subform. I'm clicking on my control subform employee phone just to make sure that that one's the one that's selected. And we want to add a control out to it. I'm going over to our controls, and I want to click on this More Controls. In this toolbar, the very last control is a control called Table Control. Table Control is basically the same as Data Sheet Control, which looks like a spreadsheet. They're all basically the same thing. So I'm going to click on this. I'm going to come down where I want my upper left-hand corner. I'm going to left-click and go over to where I want my lower right-hand corner. release the control. This opens up a little dialog box and asks me, what fields do I want to add from my employee phone to my control table or data sheet? I want them all to go in, so I'm going to click the double arrow button and finish. I'm going to stretch out the notes a little longer and maybe the description. And I'm going to close my form navigator as well as my more controls. Let's go into our design mode on off. Here we see all the data that we want to see, going to the next record, previous record. And if we use our form controls, we're going to the forward and previous. When we click into our subform, using our form controls forward and next, that works for inside the subform. But when we use our buttons that we placed onto our form, these buttons that we placed onto the form only work for the employee table. Since we have the employee on our main form, we really don't need the employee ID in our subform. So I'm going to go back into design mode and right-click and delete this field. Now we have a little more room to stretch out our notes field. I'm going to save this, close it, rename this from form employees to ODB34 employees add subform, and save our database.